Hello everyone, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. Myself Surbhi Jaggi, your science educator. So today we are going to start our second chapter of class 6 science, that is components of food. So let's start with our second chapter.
Topics to be covered in this chapter are food, different nutrients in food, tests to detect the presence of starch, proteins and fats, balanced diet, malnutrition and deficiency diseases. So in this class, in this video, we are going to discuss mainly three main important nutrients, that is carbohydrates, fats and proteins. Okay, and rest of the nutrients and rest of the topic we will discuss in our next class. So let's start with our basic introduction. So we have already discussed quite a bit about food in our previous lesson, where we saw what are the main sources of food, why do we eat food. We have discussed all about basic things, right? So let's start. Okay, what do different food items contains? What do you eat usually? What do you eat? You eat different kinds of food, right? But kya sirf aap roti khate ho? Roti ke saath sabji bhi zarur khate hoge. Kya sirf aap chawal khate ho? Ya chawal ke saath dal bhi khate hoge? So my question is, why do meals usually consist of such a distribution? Kyun hota hai itna distribution? Because different food items are made up of different ingredients, and this ingredients contain some components that are needed by our body, and the components are called nutrients. So basically, what does food provide? Food provides nutrients which are important for our body. Without this, we can't even survive. We can't able to survive. So these are required for the growth, for the maintenance, for the repair of our body. Now can you define what are nutrients? You all know that nutrients are present in food, but what are the function of food? What are the function of nutrients? Nutrients provide energy, right? So nutrients are the substances that an organism needs for growth, repair and maintenance of its body. So now let's understand the major components of food. Basically, there are 5 major nutrients of food: carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. Roughage and water are also required, but if I say the major components of food, then carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. So let's start with carbohydrates. So carbohydrates, they are the energy giving foods. Carbohydrates provide energy to the body. Basically, there are 2 type of carbohydrates. Let us see that. That is sugar and starch. Okay. So sugars are simple carbohydrates. They used to provide energy immediately. They have a sweet taste. Example, glucose and fruits such as banana, papaya, mangoes and grapes. These are simple carbohydrates. And what about starch? It is a complex carbohydrates. Plants store energy in the form of starch. It provides energy comparatively slowly than sugar. So carbohydrates provide energy to the body. Okay, let us see some examples which you love eating so much. For example, pasta, right? For example, rice, atta, bread, potato, they all have carbohydrates. So I'm not saying that rice has only carbohydrate in it. What I am saying is carbohydrate is the component that is extensively present in the rice. Okay, you can see some of the carbohydrate sources, like rice has carbohydrate, atta has carbohydrate, bread has carbohydrate, okay, potato has carbohydrate. So these are the carbohydrate sources. Now proteins. What are proteins? Proteins are called bodybuilding foods. They are necessary for growth and repair of the body. Proteins can be obtained from plants and animal sources. Example, soybean nuts, pulses. Animal sources of proteins: fish, eggs, milk and milk products. Okay, so basically the proteins help the body to grow, and they also help repair the injured and worn out parts of the body. So pulses, let us see some of the sources of proteins. These are the some plant sources of protein and these are some animal sources of protein. So pulses contain comparatively more proteins than other food items obtained from plants but have much more carbohydrates than proteins. For example, beans, gram, peas. Okay? So now, fats. Fats are also called energy-giving foods. They give us more energy than carbohydrates and they are obtained from both plants and animals. Example, butter and ghee. Right? Butter, ghee, nuts, oil, fishes, these all are the sources of fats. So fats also provide warmth. They also keep the body warm. They are present in plant as well as animal food products. Okay? So edible oils from plants such as groundnut, coconut and sunflower contains fats. So now the question is, how do we test that which nutrient is present in any food item? Okay, in the given food item. These are the sources of fats and oils. Okay? So how do we test? Question is, how do we test that which nutrient is present is in which food item, right? अभी तो हमने पढ़ लिया कि हाँ, अभी आपको sources बता दिए कि आपके potato में carbohydrate होते हैं और fats आपके oils में होते हैं, protein आपका milk में, अभी आपको बता दिया. But जब आपको नहीं पता हो then how you will do, how do we test? So we will do the small test. So let's start with the starch test. Okay, how do you test that starch is present in given food item? If I ask you to test the presence of starch in potato, how you will test? So the steps are, take some rice grains and grind them. Put powdery rice in a test tube. Add a few drops of iodine solution and shake well. Do you observe some color change? Yes, of course you will see a color change, that is blue-black color. Blue-black color shows that starch is present in rice. You can perform this test on potato, wheat, apple and bread. You can see this. Okay, so to test the presence of starch in a food item, what do you need? Iodine solution, 2 drops of iodine solution. When you put 2 drops of iodine solution on food item, if the color changes to blue-black, that means the starch is present. If the color doesn't change to blue-black, that means starch is absent. Okay? Now, let's see the fats test. How do you test the presence of fat in any of the food item, in any of the given food item? So to test the presence of fats in a food item, take some oil and rub it on a paper. The paper becomes greasy. What you will observe that the paper becomes greasy and translucent. This shows the presence of oil in fats. Okay. Or you can wrap a few groundnuts in a newspaper and crush them and remove the crushed groundnuts from the paper. Let the paper dry for about 10 minutes. You will see after some time that oily patch on the paper. That oily patch shows the presence of oil in fats. You can see this. Oil rubbed on a paper. Okay? And another activity I told you, that wrap a few groundnuts in a newspaper and crush them, remove the crushed groundnuts from the paper, let the paper dry for about 10 minutes and you will observe the oily patch on the paper. Okay? Now, test of protein. Test for proteins. Okay? How you test the presence of proteins in food item? Just take some crushed beans or a piece of egg, or you can take a teaspoon of boiled dal paste. Okay, and add water in it, little water to it. Take half of this solution in a test tube and add 2 to 3 drops of copper sulfate solution. Basically, copper sulfate solution is a salt, and then add 10 drops of caustic soda solution. Caustic soda solution is sodium hydroxide, NaOH. And if the solution becomes purple, then it shows the presence of protein. Purple, or you can say violet. ठीक है, वॉलेट, इफ द वॉलेट कलर डेवलप्स देन द फूड कंटेन्स प्रोटीन, एंड इफ द वॉलेट कलर एब्सेंट देन द फूड डजेंट कंटेन प्रोटीन्स. आर यू गेटिंग माई पॉइंट? So we study three types of test. First is starch, second is test for fats, third is test for proteins. For starch we used iodine solution. If it turns blue black, then starch is present. And for fats we just observe the oily patch on the paper. And for proteins we used copper sulfate solution, 2 to 3 drops, and 10 drops of, you can say, caustic soda. Caustic soda is NaOH, that is sodium hydroxide, and if the violet color or purple color develops, then the food contains proteins. So that's all for today's class. In next class, we will study about other nutrients, that is vitamins, minerals, water, fiber, as well as some diseases, some deficiency diseases. Okay, bye everyone, have a nice day.